Hello, candidates. Hope you're enjoying your time together with your parents at home. Today, still, your head teacher going to take you over in mathematics. Last time you studied mathematics, you were with the teacher Jacob, and he was taking you through this topic, that is length, mass, and capacity. And he concentrated so much on length at first. And then in length, you looked at the area of the square. And as he was leaving, he left you with an activity for you to work out those questions. There were four questions, and I cannot go to the next lesson unless we have reviewed. Why? We need to get the answers and see if exactly that's what we did. Then the other thing is that there are some concerns that were raised by you on the platform, and maybe your parents also called us, that we also need to iron out some of those concerns. And the questions, the first question was requiring you to find the area of the squares. There were three. And then I'm not going to go through all the questions, but I'll be giving you the answers. And you follow exactly, you follow through and see whether that were the correct answers. At the same time, those were the correct steps that we are supposed to take on. Now, on question one, I'm going to concentrate so much on that part A of the square. And I know many of you that is the first thing you got right, because you have been doing that from your primary form. But as I'm going through that question, the one you have already got the answer, but there are some questions that were raised on that very part that we are handling. I have a square here. According to the work that was given to you, if I'm not mistaken, part A had this square. Part A had that square, and it was 6 centimeters. It was 6 centimeters. But the concern that was on that area of a square was, why is the area in square centimeters, not in cubic units? And that's what exactly I want to show you, that the area is that. Why square units? I want us to look at this. I'm going to have to draw this. I want you to watch what I do. Maybe you also be able to explain to your judges sitting there that the area is in square units. I'm going to count together. Now I have drawn the squares, and why have I drawn it that way? I want you to relate it with what is here. I have drawn 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have drawn 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is a square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, I'm not going to use the formula. Each square here has its own measurement. And the measurements, without the one I've written here, it is in squares, but in units that we don't know. That's why I said, we say square units. Now, here I'm going to bring the centimeters and attach them to this square. Now, this box 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If we have divided 6 centimeters with these 6 boxes here, how many centimeters will each box have? Please, don't deceive me. Now, when I divide this with these boxes, Each one is going to be 1 centimeter. Therefore, this one is 1 centimeter, this one is another centimeter, those are 2, these are 3, these are 4, 5, 6. Even up, 1, 2, 3 centimeters, 4 centimeters, 5 centimeters, 6 centimeters. Now I want to find the area. What is area? What is area? That is another question. People know how to find the area, but they don't know what it means. According to you, even ask your neighbor, even ask your dad, what is area according to you? I want us to look at what we mean by area. Area is the space occupied by a flat, one. Tell me, area is the space occupied by a flat shape. I want you to look at the word flat shape. Your tables where you said they have the top. When I put that top on the ground, the flat part of that area is flat, and then you cover that. When you look at this square, it is also on a surface. It is covered, but it is covered by smaller squares. If I got my book, this book, this is an atlas, but it is a book. If I want to find the area, what does it mean? What is space here? Because this is a flat thing I can put. Don't bring your kettle. Some of you are going to say we are finding the area of the kettle. We are finding the area of our head. Therefore, if I have this book, and I say I want to find the area of this atlas, area, because this is a flat thing. So I'm looking at this. I'm looking at this area, that is all occupied by a flat shape. That is the area. Now, when you look at this area of this square, it is now a flat thing that has been placed somewhere. What is that part that is covered by this? Is what we refer to as area. You also find more definitions for area, but for now, I want you to take that. Now, for something to be in area, we use this square. We divide that space where that flat shape sits into squares. In mathematics, that's how we find the space. That space where that atlas you have seen, that space I have removed, you go on dividing those parts, the squares. You must have those squares there. Therefore, for this one, we're going to find this space. How? By getting the number of squares of this shape. And the number of squares in this shape is going to give us the total area. Therefore, let's count this space in four squares together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36 squares. I think many of you have this answer. And if I'm not mistaken, if that's the answer that your daddy has. 36C. Should we read it like that? No. The units are there for this square, that each square has a centimeter, and here there are 6 centimeters. Then we bring those units because they have been given to us. Now, since we are dealing with the squares in that space, the flat shape, that space, we are dealing with the squares, that's why it comes there to be called the square. This one stands for the square. Therefore, our answer for that is 36 squares.
square centimeters. For this case, they are 36 square centimeters. So if you also drew this and gave me the answer this, I will give you 100% because you have formed the edge. So it is not only about cramming the formula, but how that come about. Now, some of you are going to ask, now you have grown that one for 6 centimeters. How about 2.5 decimeters from the answers you have there? That's why the formula now has come in. Because we need to simplify what mathematicians need to simplify things. They didn't make things easy. That's why now the formula came. But they say that to find the area of this, you shall find psi times psi. Y times. I'm going to explain to you. Y times. Now, when you look at this, the side of this is 6 centimeters. This side also is 6 centimeters. So if I'm dealing with area, I'm going to multiply this times that, that we got, that is 6. Then I multiply this times that, I'm going to get squares, centimeters, square centimeters. I'm not going to add, because when I add 6 plus 6, I'm going to go to get 12. So I can't add. And yet these are 36. If I'm dividing 6, divided by 6, I'll get 1. And yet the whole area is 36. Therefore, to simplify for bigger square objects, like you have a dining table that is square for very big. Some of you have square houses. Others have square tanks. If you're getting their measure, you don't want ones that draw squares where the flat and the square tanks, the bottom of the square tanks. That's why you're supposed to use that. You have understood that. That was one of the concerns that was raised. Understand before you apply. I'm going to give answers for the main parts of question one. For part eight was 36 square centimeters. Then for part B, it was 6.25 square decimeters. 6.25 square decimeters. You have the answer, go through. Then for part C, we had 1.7 out of 9 square meters. And I believe you have got the answer correct. Answer for number 2 was 100. The answer is 169 square meters. Square meters. Please be mindful of the units. We are dealing with area, and area has to do with this square. So it must be square units. That is for number 2. Number 3. The answer was 309.76 square meters. And for number 3, in your working, there was something I wanted us to remind ourselves. It was something like that, out of 100. There was a step that you have in number 3. And then teacher Jacob told you that you cancel this zero, and if this is the whole number, the point is at the end. You move backwards. That is another point. Then this one, you move again. That is another point. Now the point comes there. That's why you come up with 309.76. Now here we have moved backwards because we are dealing with division. When we are dealing with multiplication, we move forward. Not. It is easier to divide by 10, by 100, by 1,000. It is easier to multiply by 10, by 100, by 1,000. When you are dividing, you move backwards. When you are multiplying, you move forward. That's what you are told by your teachers. Now, the last question, that's number 4. Number 4 had something you are supposed to be careful of. They said that we are finding the area of a square garden. Area of a square garden.
imaginary guide we have at home, it is in square form, with the 50,000 with 50,000 centimeters. But it's saying that the area is supposed to be in square meters. The area is supposed to be in square meters. Now, that question was a word problem. And the word problem is involving the way we execute, the way we are doing our work, the way we are doing, we are applying mathematics in our daily lives. Therefore, whenever you're reading that question, you expand your thinking and understanding in your areas of operation. Can you have square gardens at your home? Can you have square something? Now, when you are answering that question, now you need to bring that knowledge that you have seen out and put it on the paper for you to manage it. So you get that kind of experience from your environment and you bring it on the paper. So you need to draw the sketch of that square garden. Did you draw the sketch of that square garden in your book? Fine. If you draw, now the other thing you needed to know, the instructions. The measurements given to you were in centimeters, but the answer required was supposed to be in square meters. Therefore, we are supposed to bring that garden into the units that they wanted, square meters. But it is very easy even for you to find meters on your garden than the centimeters on your garden. So even the teacher was wise in setting that question. Because the garden looks big, 50,000 centimeters. And then you want to find the area in square meters. It will simplify the work for you. Therefore, you needed to draw. Now, what happened there? I want to ask you what happened. One, the square garden, that is my sketch. Some of you say, teacher, you are not fair. And that one will be a garden. This is now a sketch of the garden. The sketch of the garden. I have drawn, but with 50,000, with 50,000 centimeters, imagine you are in the... So now I have condensed that garden from the environment where you are now on the paper. This is 50,000. Oh my God, I think it's supposed to be 5,000. Sorry. I think it's supposed to be 5,000. I'm sorry to mislead you. I think it's supposed to be 5,000 centimeters. Please don't get scared. The answer is correct as we are going to rule. So now this is our garden. But the instructions we are telling us to find the area in square meters. Square meters. Before you can proceed, please get the requirements of the question. A question not in centimeters, but in square meters. What does it mean? I think here I need to change the centimeters to meters. Then I can be able to find the area. I need to change from centimeters to the meters that they want. Then I can find the area. But remember, we have been learning proportions and application now has come for the proportions. What is the relationship between the centimeters and the meters? You are changing the centimeters to meters. The order in which I have placed this is also very important to you. The order in which I have placed. I have begun in centimeters because I'm moving from centimeters. If I'm supposed to move from meters, then I will set meters to centimeters. So the order here matters. I'm moving from centimeters to meters. What is the relationship? Mathematical. The relationship is 1 meter is equal to, let me first write it here. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. Now, in relation to this, in relation to my order here, and I have placed here, I'm going to say 100 centimeters is going to give me 1 meter. Because I want meters,
If 100 centimeters are going to give me 1 meter, how about this? I want you to mind. How about this? 5,000 centimeters. Are they going to give me more meters or less? I think they're going to give me more. You are giving me the answer. Thank you. They want to have more. And in proportions, we know that on the slide, if it is more, which of these is more? I think it is 5,000 centimeters is more. All over 100 centimeters, then you multiply. I like that you are following proportions and you learned proportions. Now, these centimeters will have to go, this one will have to go, this one will have to go. Now we are remaining with 50 meters. Now this is the length of the garden now we have seen. It was in 5,000 centimeters. Now it has been brought to meters. I think now it is easier for you to get the meter. Because it is very easy to measure your garden using a meter than the smaller centimeters. Now they want the area. You know the formula? Formula is that side times side is equal to area. The order that I'm not mad. Here I said area is equal to this. Even here, side times side is equal to area. And these are 50 meters. And these are 50 meters. I'll get the area. What is your area there? For the steps, this is 500 square meters. I think now you want to ask me a question. 2,500 square meters. Why square? I have explained. Why square? I have explained. From there we can continue. Now we have seen what Mr. Okori gave us, and we have summarized this lesson, and you have fully understood the area of a circle. I mean the area of a square, where you are supposed to use the formula and the steps you took you through. And now you have got the whole picture of what you mean by area. Now the whole picture has been got. Now, for example, this part of the plot on number 4, we say that the plot has been given the measurement. Now for this case, the plot is 50 meters. And then they wanted me to find the area of that plot of land. Now, assuming someone comes and says, that land of yours you are having behind your home is 2,500 square meters. And then someone says, what is the size? What is the length of each side of that plot of land? That is exactly what we want to look at today. Given the area of the square, and we are required to find the side of the length of each side of the square. That is what I want us to go through today and see how best we can make use of the area of the square. So my heading is finding the length of a square given the area. That is our area of focus today. That is our area of focus today. I want to begin with our flat shapes. Let's first move away from the garden. The square gardens. Let's look at the shapes that are in the form of the square, but the area has been given to us. I have a question. I have my square here. I don't know which square, I don't know whether it is your book, whether it is your table. I want you to imagine. Look at the measurements and imagine what it is at your home. Which square
object are you seeing there? If I have the area of the square below, of the square given, the area of the square given is 144 square centimeters. Now what is it? 144. Is that a book? Is that something? I want you to imagine. The area given here is 144 square centimeters. Now what is the size of the side? What is the length of this from here to here? So that is exactly what we are supposed to do. I want us to use exactly what Mr. Okore gave us. He gave us the formula. I think we can use that to find the side. Mr. Okore said that side times the side is going to give us the area. Do you recall that? Please don't doze. Some of you have started dozing. Side times side is equal to area. What is missing here? According to the statement, the area of the square given, what is given? This square given is 144 square centimeters. Find the side. Find the length of each side. And each side is not. All of the length, this side is equal to this, is equal to that. So when you get this, you have got all other sides. But he said that side times side. Now, in your formula, what is missing? When I look into this statement, the area is there, but the side is not there, the side is not there. But we can build on from that. We can build on from that. Now, I want you to look that side times side. When I multiply side times side, what do I do? Thank you. It is side square. But there are some of you who have said two sides. There are some of you who have said two sides. That a side and a side, therefore you get two sides. This is multiplication. When I add k plus k, that is 2k. But it is different from when I multiply k times k. This is k square. Those who have got it wrong, we are together there. Side times side is side square. But remember, the area is 144 square centimeters. Wow. We want the side, but the side here is side square. Oh my God. I remember when we are dealing with geometry, we are solving for unknowns. That is P5, that is P6. Even in P7, I had your teachers, when you had just reported from home, we talk about solving equations where you have unknowns, and those unknowns were having squares. How do you find S when you have a square of the unknown? And you have equal signs here, you have two terms here. You have a square here, you have an unknown here, it can be K, then you have that. Oh yeah, we use the square root. Thank you so much. The square root sign will remove a power on the unknown. But these things are working correctly, they are together. Therefore, we need to use the square root sign, even the other side. We need to use the square root sign. Not careful. The square root has come in. Why? We are supposed to remove off the square. Now, as we are applying the square root is coming on 44. That is another challenge all of us we are supposed to address. Now, this one is very easy to remove. This one is very easy to remove because side is square. I can as well expand. I've got the square sign. Side squared is side times side. This one. Now, I want also to expand this. I want also to expand this as I've done here. Side squared is this. How about this? Side squared is this. What about this? Remember application of the topics that we have been learning. Now, when you talk about square root of 144, you learned that. I'm very sure. Therefore, can you find the square root of this? Can you find the square root of this? Because this is a number. It is very easy to find the square root. But I want to ask before, we need to, it has to look like this. Because the number is alike, it has to look like this. So we need to find the square. How do we find the square root? By prime factorization. Thank you. I want you to note, it is very easy for us to find the square root by prime factorization. We have other forms, but we talked about prime factorization. Prime factorization. To find the square root. Prime factorization. So we bring, we prime factorize. Now, this is the biggest challenge we have been facing to prime factorize. I want you to note three things that are going to help you that we, the teacher has told us about prime factorization. One, divisibility test is very easy. Some of you are going to find it hard. Now I'm going to give you one, but you can spend about 4 hours finding the square root. But if you have the knowledge of divisibility, divisibility test. There are so many ways we can find. For example, 2, 3, 5, 7, why have I used those numbers? Why have I used 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, but in between there are so many numbers. Recall, prime. We use prime factors. We use prime factors. That's why I'll skip 9 there. Now, today you have, how do you know that number is divisible by 7? How do you know that number is divisible by 13, by 11? But for this question, let's first look at this. How do you know that number is divisible by 2? 1, the number must be an even, which is okay. It ends with an even number, that one is okay. It ends with a 0. Any number ends with a 0 with the an even number is divisible by 2. So can 2 go here? Thank you. 3. A number is divisible by 3 if the sum of these digits, this plus this plus this, is a multiple of 3. Multiples of 3. 3, 6, 9, 12. You know those? Multiples. Have them. 1 plus 4, 5, 5 plus 4, 9. Oh my God. Even 3 is divisible by 3. Very fast. 5. A number is divisible by 5 if it ends with 0 or 5. Now, let's use these ones. Which of these cards is a prime number and is divisible by 144? The first one, 2. Thank you. 2. 72. C, is it divisible by 2? Yes. How about by 3? Yes. Now, let's begin with the smallest. That is 2. 2, 36. Uh-huh. 18. Thank you. Thank you. Now we have stopped here. Some of you can say by 3, 1, but 1 cannot be a prime number. When you test there, then you need to consider this. Need to consider those. And somewhere we put here 1, but 1 cannot be a prime number, then they consider if 3 comes here. And we need to look at that. What the teacher said that when you are finding the square root, when you are finding the square root, we group them. When we are squaring, I'm going to come out and say something. We group them. How many groups? 1, 2, 3. We group them because they have the same numbers. These are two pairing. Now, when you are finding a square, you multiply the number by itself. When you are getting a square root, it's one of the numbers. The one you use to find the square root, I mean the square, then becomes the square root. Therefore, we shall pick one from each group. If you are talking about a square root, one from this group, another two from that group, then 1, 3 from that group. What are you going to have? We are going to have 12. Thank you. Now, what does it look like this? How am I going to put it here? How am I going to put it here? Oh my gosh. This is 12, but I want it to look like this. So this one becomes a square root of 144. So to get 144, you get this number, multiply it twice. I want it to look like this so that we don't change the meaning. So this one is going to be 12, the units are there, centimeters. And then here, 12 centimeters. Why have I written centimeter and centimeter? Why have I not put centimeter square and centimeter square? I put a centimeter and a centimeter because a centimeter and a centimeter, I'll get this square. That's how it is there. Now, after I have been helped to find this, then I'm going to have it this way. Square side, even this one, square root, 12, centimeters, then square. I've been very slow here. You must be very careful. I want to come back here. Square, square root of this, square root of this. I expand it. Why? I want to find the square root of this. That's how it has come, and that's how we have got it. Then you bring it back here in this format, then you bring the other 12 in the centimeter, then you square it. Now it's going to be very easy. Why? There is something now in common here. I have brought it here. There was nothing so much common here, but you have seen something very common here. What is that common? What is that common? What is that common? Okay. Some of you have seen square root is common. Thank you. Square root is common. Mm-hmm. What else is common there? Square. Someone was going to say even this one is common, this one is common. You will remove them, but you have not have found the square root. Now, when you reach here, this square will move with this square root sign. This one will move with this square root sign. Some of you are wondering why. How can a 2 go with a square root? How can a 2 go with a square root? My dear, you are still studying. But I want to briefly tell you that a square root is power. For example, if I say square root of 9, this one is the 9th power I have. But remember, there is another 2. A power and a power are half times 2. You are going to get 9. But that one will find it at the senior level, that this one and this one will have to cross and will have nothing to worry about. Now, what have you remained with? I have remained with this side, and this side. I have many with 12 centimeters. Therefore, the side of that square is 12 centimeters. Wow, wow, wow. Is that so hard for you? I don't believe. I don't believe. The rest of the examples is going to be a walkover. It's going to be a walkover. Let me have one example, then we practice. Then we practice. Then we practice. Now, let me bring about our square table. A square table in your rooms. A square table in the compound. But they have given us the area of that square table. For example, let me have this example. The area of a square table. Sorry. The area of a square table. Is, oh my God, the area of a square table is 6
and a quarter square meters. Do you have such a table? Big, big, big. But the area is 6 1/4 square meters. Now, what is the size? What is the length? What is the length of the table? What did I say? Now we have moved away from the flat shapes in the class. Now we have tables, we have garden, but they have given us the area. Oh yeah, we bring a sketch in our book. We bring the sketch. And the sketch now here is gonna be, now this is our table, Represent the table in form of a square. This is our table. And it is, the area is 6 1/4 square meters. Have you moved out from the table now on the paper? Fine. If it is a garden, you have moved out from the garden now on the paper? Fine. Now we need to find the size of that table. But remember, those who can still follow with me, you have that side, are you following me? Times side is gonna give us the area. Okay? The area. Thank you. Marvelous. Side squared is 6 1/4 square meters. Oh my God, this is now a bit easy for us. What do I do? Please move with us to remove a square. Oh yeah. We introduce the square root here. That is the only way we can remove a square there. And then the square root here. Oh my God, 6 1/4 meters square. Should we cancel? Because we are used to cancel square. Oh my God, because we need to find the square root, so it should not remove. All right. Are we going to find the square root when it's like this? Improper fraction. Let's put the improper fractions here. Improper fractions. The square root of side square is going to have. Oh my God. This times this. Changing mixed fractions into improper fractions. This times this. 24. 24 plus 1. Thank you. You learned. You learned here very well. We have a fraction. What are we going to do? We find the square root of 25 and the square root of 4. This one is very easy for you because the prime factor is that. But for this one is too small for you. Alright. Now, for the square root of 25, you are giving me 5. I like that. Square root of 4 is giving me 2. Oh my God. Now what is the fraction? After the square root, what is the fraction after the square root? Oh my God. The fraction is now 5 out of 2. 5 out of 2. Remember, we are bringing now 12 back into the square root sign. How do we bring it? Alright. Now this one comes to be the square root of side times side. Square root, thank you. 5 out of 4, thank you. 5 out of 2, oh my God. Okay, thank you. The units, meters. 5 out of 2 units, meters, fantastic. Then we are together. We are together there. Oh, we take back this
sine square. You shall have so we shall have 5 out of 2 meters square root squared. It is done. This one moves with this, this one moves with this, shall make me inside 5 out of 2 meters. Should we say the answer is that? Yes, no? No. Why? The question, the area of a square table is 6.25 meters. 6.25 square meters. Therefore, even our answer should look like the question to us. What is the mixed fraction for 5 out of 2? Alright. Sine is equal to 2.5 meters. You have been bright children. That is how we are supposed to be finding the sine if the area has been given. There is nothing that can come that can scare you. Not. When you are finding the square root, be cautious of the factorization, be cautious of the prime factors, be cautious of the divisibility test, and be cautious with the multiples. And my dear candidates, if you want to find calculations very easy for you, practice multiples. When you practice multiples, division, multiplication, addition is going to be very easy for you. If you ask me, what is 12 times 9? Even when I'm about to die, I will first tell you that if 12 times 9 is 108, then I will collapse and die. So please, while at home, fix there, please have the multiples in your brains. There's a number of activities that we have set, and they work. I want you to practice. We want you to practice these questions. You will go and upload. My dear children, we have spent a lot of time preparing this work for you. And please, take it as important as any other thing in life. Please, practice and do everything as the teacher has told you. We love you to come back here when you're alive. Please follow up every step. Stay in your homes. Coronavirus is killing people all over the world. You should not be one of them. We love you so much. Please be ready for the next lesson. Bye-bye.